Welcome to my YouTube channel, guys. Today we're going to wire and program this DI615. Okay, this one, guys, is commonly used in display chiller. Mostly this is glass chiller, but it can be used also as a freezer. Aligayang pagdating sa aking channel, guys. Ngayon, poprogram natin at iwawiring ng DI615 na model. Okay? Ito ay ginagamit sa glass chiller. Pwede rin sa freezer. But, mostly for chiller use lang siya. Okay? Okay, guys. Itong wire na to is ito yung 12 volts. Okay? Wire natin kagad. Sorry, it's DJ. The other one, it has a 220. But this model is for the 12 volts. Okay? And now, this two white here is for the NTC sensor. Okay, we're going to wire it up here. Okay, the base is for the NTC sensor. But during testing, guys, I use pipe sensor of air conditioning. Okay, they are the same sensor. It's your advantage if you know electronics, guys. It doesn't matter what is the appearance, as long as you know what is inside. Okay, baka sabihin nyo, bakit ang ginamit niya is pang aircon? Ayun, paggagamit niya is pang ref. There might be a question about that, guys. Anyway, we're not talking about electronics here. We are here to discuss about how to wire this one and how to program it. Okay, guys, later you will going to discuss to you that only 4 parameters is intended for the users, for us technician to change this setting, okay? And the other 4 is for the manufacturer. But both I'm going to teach. Okay, next, guys. Okay, I have here with me a LED. It's my load for compressor. Okay, now I have here evaporator fan motor. Okay, and I want to run this with the compressor. Okay, if you want to run your evaporator fan motor, just connect in series with this light. Okay, because the manufacturer recommend it. Okay, so line will be here and load for the evaporator fan motor will be up here. Okay, but I'm not going to do that, because what if it is in night time? Are you going to turn it off the light to save electric? And it doesn't want that the fan motor will be stopped. Otherwise, the evaporator will form ice build. Okay, magkaka-ice build up po tayo, guys. Kapag pinatay natin ang light, we turn this off during the night time. For the operation, for daytime, it's okay. It's gonna work. But I'm going to run this with the compressor. Okay. So, this is my line for compressor, going to take this and this one. Okay. I'm connecting it in series. Okay, guys. And don't worry about the output relay of this control because it's rated 25 ampere. Okay. It's rated 25 ampere. So if my pagkay mag-ala guys output relay ng control na ito because yung output relay niya is 25 ampere. So assuming na ang ginagamit natin is 1 horsepower para sa ating chiller at ang fan motor naman natin is less than 1 amp, so kayang-kaya. But the question is, what if I'm going to use it in a bigger cold room? Yes, it can. Just use contactor and you won't have any more problem to come. One million problem. Okay guys, next. Now, this line here, line for the compressor is about the fan motor. Okay. But here, okay, this is the relay guys, so I'm going to connect it here. Okay, and next both neutral, I'm going to connect that also in series, and I'm going to use gagamitin natin ng terminal guys. Okay, so next, let's plug in here. Gagamitin lang natin siya ng connector. Okay guys, later I'm gonna show you the diagram, but this time just pay attention. Okay, now I'm going to plug in here. So this side is for the AC source, which is the 220, and this side is the 12 volts. Okay, so I'm going to plug in here. Sasalpak natin ito sa AC source guys na 220. Okay, guys, I'm going to the AC source. Okay, since all my neutral is connected now, itong white na wire guys ipapunta na sa ating AC source. Sorry, it's DJ. This red here, I'm going to plug in here. Since this is the power switch, I'm going to plug in here. Okay? Okay. Then, this white and red goes to the AC source. Now, so supply natin guys itong line na ito. Okay? Papunta dito. Stand for live. Okay, so here let's just plug in there and plug into this step down transformer. Okay, then higpitan lamang po natin siya. Okay, as simple as that. Now guys, sasaksak natin siya. Okay, if you have AC plug, better install it easy plug, okay? Para hindi siya galaw-galaw. Okay? So, just plug into the AC source here. And we're going to turn the switch on. And here is it. By the way, itong live natin is mamaya natin siya itap, okay? Para later we're going to tap here, okay? Because it might be quite noisy while I'm speaking here, okay? Here, this live here, so I'm going to tap here. Since the operation is light, which means the compressor now is going to light up. since the load is, okay, take a look. If I'm going to tap here to the line, the load for the compressor and the fan motor evaporator is going to activate and look. Okay, so makaka-istorbo siya. It will disturb our programming mode, so I'm going to unplug. Okay, and the connection is there here. Okay, this four parameter here is only for the user. Okay, set by user. I'm going to pull this because I have a question from one of my viewer. I'm going to prove to him that all digital control for refrigerator is almost the same. Magkakapareho lang sila. So I have here DI and Dixel. Okay, for the set time in Dixel, it's been called set point. Okay, we will change that set point. Okay, and set point, guys, for the chiller is between 1 to 4. Okay, so 1 to 4 for the freezer, it's either -18 to -23. Okay, so it's up to the customer or to the company you're working, what is their standard temperature. Now here, to enter the parameter, just press the function button. Okay, and look, so under there, which is the set point, okay, for the Dixel set point, we're going to set that value to here, 1 degree Celsius. Okay, I'm going to set that to 1 degree Celsius. Okay, press the arrow down. Okay, and after that, press the function again. Now under here, which is the differential, I'm going to put a 4. Okay, the cut in cut off of the compressor, just press again. Okay, 1, just press. Okay, it's already set to number 4. Okay, so here are the defaults, guys. And next, my differential is 4 and the default cycle is 6. So if you want 5, if you want 7, no problem. Okay, now there 6, if you want 7, if you want 5, no problem. Set again, and the first time default is 30. If you want 25, no problem. If you want 20, no problem. Okay, if you're going to decrease this value, you must also increase the defrost cycle. Okay, for example 6. Okay, you reduce the binawasan nyo ito, guys. Ginawa nyo 20. Ito gawin nyo naman 7 or 8 or 9. Okay? So, but, okay, that's it. So, let's this defrost time here, we're going to make it 30, which is the default. Okay. After 10 seconds, it will memorize. Here, let's explain that one, guys. Okay, the setting I installed here is the chiller mode. Okay, so under here, what I installed is 1 degree Celsius. Okay, and the differential I put it 4. Okay, 4 degree Celsius. This differential, guys, is the cut-in cut-off of our compressor. If you're my previous subscriber, so how is that happen? For example, your compressor run and it reached the value of 1 degree Celsius. Now inside the cabinet, the compressor off. Okay. Now the value we put here, which value niyan guys, is under ng differential. Okay. So differential na to, si compressor natin is mag-go on ulit siya. Compressor on upon reaching the 4 degrees Celsius na value na nilagay natin dito sa HY naman pagdating sa diesel. At mag-go on siya. Okay? Status niya mag-go on. Pag lumalit yung cabinet natin, if the cabinet become cold again and it reaches the value of 1 degrees, mag-go off ulit si compressor. Okay? Mag-go off. So, yan ang purpose ng differential. Itong set point, ito yung lowest na degrees na isinet natin dito sa counter natin. Okay? Lowest degrees. So, dun siya mamatay, dito siya mag-go on. Okay? Compressor will off here, the compressor will on here. Now, let's go to defrost. Itong defrost cycle na to, guys, kung gagawin natin itong 3 defrost cycle, ang 6 na value na naka-store dyan guys is 6 hours, meaning na default nang naka-store dito is ito, mag-defrost ang ating unit 24 divided by 6 equals 4. Itong 4 na to, every 4 hours magde-defrost ang ating unit. Okay? Magde-defrost siya within the cycle of defrost time na ang naka-indicate is 30. Okay? Defrost time niya is 30 minutes. Okay. Question. Okay guys, since pinuprove natin na may similarity ang mga control, so dito sa DI natin is defrost cycle, nakalagay naman sa DIXI natin is IDF, na kung may meaning ito guys, ang IDF naman sa DIXI is stand for length of defrost. Okay, length of defrost, dito defrost cycle. Dito naman sa DEI and under sa defrost time, MDF sa diesel. Ang nakalagay naman sa diesel is interval between defrost cycle. So, pares lang sila guys. Okay? Pares lang sila. So, dito nakalagay 6. Okay? 6. Na ang 6 is magde-defrost siya every 4 hours. Okay? Na within every 4 hours magde-defrost siya, and the value of the time is 30 minutes. Okay, every 4 hours ang unit natin is magde-defrost ng 30 minutes. So pwede natin bawasan to, pwede natin dagdagan to. Okay, halimbawa ginawa lang natin itong 3, so every 8 hours magde-defrost ang ating unit. Okay guys, set by manufacturer, minimum set 10, minimum set point sa diesel, set point sa diesel may range to na hanggang -50 up to 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, at ang default nito guys is 0 hanggang 30 Fahrenheit. Okay, so ang unit nito is degrees Celsius at saka degrees Fahrenheit. Okay? Fahrenheit. Ngayon, ang number 2 naman guys is temp calibration. Under lang temp calibration. okay, calibration yan, mahaba, is within the range of negative 8 to positive, okay, degrees Celsius. At ang default nyo guys is 0. Na-discuss ko na to guys sa aking Dixel about calibration, okay. At ang unit nya is same kesa unit, okay, degrees Celsius at Fahrenheit. Okay, next, pangatlo, compressor delay, compressor delay protection, delay protection, okay, protection. Ngayon ang range nito guys is 0 to 15 minutes, okay, minutes, minutes. At ang default niya is 3 minutes. Kung gusto mong gawin 2 minutes, gawin mong 5 minutes, no problem, it's up to you. Pero ito set by manufacturer. Ito guys, di ko sana ituturo sa inyo to para iwas, tanong na, ituturo ko na. At ang next guys is unit selection. Unit selection, okay. At ito ay degrees Celsius o Fahrenheit. For example, nasa US kayo at ang gamit nila doon sa bandang US, ang gamit nila is Fahrenheit. Sa atin dito sa Asian is degrees Celsius. Okay, if you want to select that, itong unit natin is naka-select sa degrees Celsius. Okay, if you want to select that, just go to the units selection at select yung Fahrenheit. Okay, so let's enter this one guys. Okay, set by manufacturer. To enter that, the unit is off. Let's press the function button and power on. Okay, okay, under here, here minimum set temp, I'm going to put that to negative 18. Oh, cannot. What seems to be the problem? Cannot add it. Okay, let's wait. I'm going to set the set point under the user manual, okay, by the user. So I'm going to enter that one. Okay, I'm going to change. Okay, same, till negative 5 only. Let's wait 10 seconds to memorize. Off. I'm going to enter here, set the manufacturer on. Okay, I'm going to set that to cannot. Cannot. Differential unit. Range, which is indicated as up to negative 50, is LI. Okay, because I'm going to show you why it's LI. Okay, to enter the manufacturer setting, press this function button and power on. Okay, the value is up to negative 0.5 only, negative 5. So even I press this one, up to there only. Okay, if I'm going to press here, it's going up. If I'm going to press here, it's going down, but up to negative 5 only. So this is not accurate guys. Okay, we've been fooled by the manufacturer. But the temperature, okay, goes back. Okay, again off. So this is questionable, okay? Questionable ito guys, okay? Ato negative 5 lang siya. So we cannot set them to freezer. So for cheater only. How about the temp? If we want to calibrate guys, same, just press the function button and power on. And the first one show you is the minimum set temperature. If you press the function button again, you are now in the calibration. Now if you want to change that, just press here, okay? Up to positive 7, then up to negative 8, okay? The default is 0, okay? Next is the compressor delay protection, okay? The stored value is 3 minutes. If you want 2 minutes, no problem. If you want 5 minutes, no problem. Okay, so let's install the restore jumpotize at 3 degrees. At set po ulit natin. Ito, yung sinasabi ko kanina, if you want Fahrenheit, just select Fahrenheit. Okay, Fahrenheit sa Westo guys. Dito tayo sa degree Celsius. Okay? Degree Celsius. Then, hayaan nyo lang siya within 10 seconds mag-i-store lahat ng value na linagay natin. So, as easy as that guys. Now, itatap natin ito. Okay? Off muna natin. Off dito. Okay? Itatap natin siya. I'm going to tap the line. Papakita ko sa inyo na under siya, okay? After the delay is 3. Okay. 3 minutes delay. Let's stop it here. And tighten. Unit on. Let's wait for 3 minutes at mag-activate yung low flow compressor natin at yung evaporator for motor natin. Okay, there. Turn motor on and the low flow compressor is on. Now, gusto kong bumaba ang temperature. I want that the temperature be lower. So I'm going to soak this sensor into this ice and let's see what's gonna happen. Let's see if the unit will stop the compressor as well as the evaporator fan motor. About the chain, okay, off guys, okay? And I'm going to remove this one, and let's see if in 4 degrees Celsius, the unit will start again. Now, I'm going to hold here so the sensor sense my body temperature. Okay, see? Nagsisignal na siya. Okay? So, let's wait. I just put this, guys, to 1 minute. Okay? Because 3 minutes is too long for me. So, the delay is only 1 minute. So, ayan, tumataas na siya kasi sinesense niya ulit yung init. Okay? But, kanina, nag-start na siya nag-blink doon sa 4 dahil sa delay. Okay, it's start up again. So if I'm going to reinsert it again, mamamatay ulit siya sa 1 degree Celsius. Yun yung differential natin guys, ha? That is differential. Okay, it's going down again. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, the unit will stop. So yan yung on off natin, ha, on off. So mamamatay siya. One more. hold this one again, and the temperature rises and it will blink. See, it blink. So let's wait and let's activate. It's only 1 minute. Now I prove to you that the differential is 4. Okay, so 4 plus the 1 minute delay. Okay, how about activate defrost, guys? Okay, to activate defrost, manual defrost, press the arrow down button and the up button, arrow up button, arrow down button, and the up button at the same time. Okay, maybe defroster, compressor will stop. Okay, defrosting now. Ito guys, nagde-defrost siya na walang defrost heater. Ang mangyayari lang sa unit natin is magpapahinga lang unit natin. Yung frost na na-accumulate niya during the operation o kaya during malfunction ito is matutunaw within 30 minutes. Okay? So, yan. Within 30 minutes na every 4 hours mag di-defrost tayo dahil may value tayo na 6. Every 4 hours mag-defrost at within the span of 30 minutes anumang frost na na-accumulate is matutunaw. So wala siyang defrost heater. Pero pag mga low temp tayo is kailangan may defrost heater. So this one is intended only for chiller. Okay? Thanks for watching.
If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the notification bell.